back on Saturday night. Still to come, we will hear from Hulk Hogan and the Macho Man Randy Savage. They are here in the arena this week, and they will react to Nick Bockwinkel's statement. Nick Bockwinkel will allow Hogan and Savage to be in the board meeting next week when the historic vote is made one way or the other about Ric Flair.
Oh, you don't think that intimidates the people they're voting? I don't think that's fair. That's not fair to Flair at all, and you know that.
Well, if you
for those two to be in there with the board meeting.
If you want to be fair to Flair, watch a little bit later on. Ric Flair will be with us. He has purchased another segment of this program. It's a hot 2 hours here on WCW Saturday night. Of course, TBS is red hot.
The brain station.
You know,
they let me in the meeting.
And not too far down the road, the Braves are going to be back. The Major Leaguers are back, and the Braves will be right here on TBS each and every week.
I guarantee you, if they vote Ric Flair back, Hogan is going to find a replacement wrestler to take his place.
Wrong. Flyin' Brian and Brain, we have in now 2 weeks, we have the tournament beginning for the United States heavyweight title. It'll be a tournament that will last through the remainder of April, through May, into June. It'll be here on Saturday night and on the main event on Sunday. It starts in 2 weeks, and next week we will have the carries.
So it'll all take place on television.
Right.
Wow.
Every bit of it.
Well, you know, that's a travesty right there, to strip Vader of his title just because he didn't comply to the fine. You lose the title in the ring, you'll win it in the ring. It's that simple.
Hey, guess what? Vader will be here later on. I'll bet you he'll be in a bad mood.
He's never been in a good mood.
Well, no, you're right.
And Hogan's in the building. This could be explosive.
Lieutenant James Earl. Drop kick. Drop toe hold. Greg finds those legs and pulls back. A good look at Flyin' Brian. I would think Flyin' Brian, they're going to seed the men 1-16. I think they're going to do it by random. We'll hear more about it next week. But Flyin' Brian's got to be considered a top seed in the tournament, wouldn't you think?
I would think every star here at World Championship Wrestling is considered for that tournament.
Yeah, and I agree with that.
But they can only have 16.
Well, they can have 16, that's right. The Sweet 16, so to speak, in WCW.
Keep them grounded. That's what you got to do. Read him his rights. You have the right to remain silent. If you give up that right, I'm going to kick your teeth in.
Sending Brian in, Lieutenant James Earl. Flyin' Brian, a flying hip scissors. Great move.
Well, he can come out of one move and go into another move. So the transition there is so smooth.
Whips him to the far side. Big back body drop. Flyin' Brian hits the ropes. Oh, big clothesline.
Yep, you have to keep Flyin' Brian, Flyin' Wine, and Brian grounded.
Brian hooks him at a vertical suplex. And now, living up to his nickname, Flyin' Brian's going to take flight here on Saturday night.
Go!
Consider him a top candidate to make the Sweet 16 for the U.S. title tournament in 2 weeks beginning here on TBS.
Now, Pillman is so quick. Goes from a backbreaker into a head scissors, takes his man over. Now, look at the elevation. Comes right down on top of him, 230 pounds. He's like dinner. He's done.
Back with more on Saturday night.